Are you confused about cholesterol? Have you heard that HDL particles are good and LDL are bad? When I was growing up in the 80s, we were told, don't eat eggs, they'll clog your arteries because of all the cholesterol. Now they tell you, go ahead, eat eggs. Dietary cholesterol doesn't matter. Have you heard that saturated fat is bad? And then you go online and you'll see carnivores, health experts, eating meat all the time. Does cholesterol not matter? Are these tests even relevant? Should we just eat whatever we want? If you're confused, you're in good company. Hey, my name is Lucas. I'm a yoga teacher. I'm a nutritional coach. I never understood this dietary cholesterol and cholesterol panel stuff. I even read an entire book just on cholesterol about 7 years ago, and I ended the book more confused than when I started. I recently read a book called Outlive by Dr. Peter Attia. He's got a great podcast as well. And I think I'm starting to understand this. I'd love to share with you what I've learned here using some silly toys and some simple analogies. Hopefully you'll understand how all of this works. Quick disclaimer, not a medical doctor. Heart disease, cardiovascular disease is the number one killer of men and women all around the world. Go see a doctor, go get tested, and the test you want, which is what we'll talk about now, is an ApoB test. If you were to go get your cholesterol tested now, I did this a few months ago, what will often come back is a number for your HDL and your LDL. The problem with this test is it's not so accurate because it's measuring the mass of the particles. It's not counting the particles. In order to count the particles, which is much more important, it's called an ApoB test. I'll explain how all of this works here in just a moment. Here's the thing. Cholesterol is essential for life. Without it, you will die. It's important for hormones like testosterone and estrogen. It's important for digestion and vitamin D synthesis and all kinds of other things in your body. And the liver is kind of the central bank of cholesterol in your body. Like a central bank, at any given time, a bunch of the money's here, a bunch of the cholesterol is here, let's call it 20%, and then it's moved to and from the liver through your blood vessels. And this process, the problem with cholesterol, or I should say the challenge with cholesterol, is that it's in the lipid family, the fat family, which means it's not water soluble. It needs a high-density lipoprotein. It needs a fat and protein to move around. Think of this lipoprotein as like a cargo truck, moving the cholesterol to where it needs to go, away from the liver, back to the liver, etc. Well, we have a couple of different types of particles, and let's think about them as kind of a highway system going through your body, or a freeway system. And the high-density lipoproteins, these are good drivers, and they have a lot more protein, whereas these have a lot more fats. They both have fats and proteins because they're lipoproteins, high density, low density, but these have a lot more proteins, and they drive really well. That means the HDL particles, they can move through your arteries. They can actually take an exit ramp and an on-ramp really, really effectively, and they never create any problems. We like these drivers. Now, over here, we have our low-density particles, and these are bad drivers, yes or yes. We have some big 16-wheeler bad drivers, and then we have some little teeny Priuses that are bad drivers as well. Now, these are not created equally because these little Priuses, behind the wheel is a 16-year-old, and they are much more prone to getting lodged in the shoulder, your endothelial wall, and developing into arterial plaque. Now, what is important when you get on the road in the morning, when you're doing your commute, is you want to know how many bad drivers and how many good drivers. And if you have, you know, six good drivers, and you've got just one bad driver behind a 16-wheeler, that doesn't make you comfortable, but you can stay out of his way. However, if you get on the road and you've got six good drivers, but you've got eight bad drivers, and a bunch of them are those 16-year-olds in Priuses, you're very likely to have an accident. And so what we want to know is how many bad drivers are on the road, and that's what your ApoB test does. Counts them up, gives you a number. Here's why this is relevant. If you got your cholesterol panel like I did, and you see HDL and LDL, your LDL number might not be giving you the full picture. It might be accurate, but in many cases, you'll find that your ApoB count is going to make you worried, and you might want to take some action more quickly. Good news about an ApoB test, they're inexpensive, $20 to $65. Insurance will usually cover them. However, you might need to ask for it. My doctor did not give me one until I asked. This is kind of a changing trend in cardiovascular health and blood panel work in general. Okay, so we have our LDL, we have our HDL, and what affects this? Is it eggs? Is it meat? And here's what we learned. In 2015, dietary recommendations for eggs and high cholesterol-containing foods were thrown out the window because dietary cholesterol, the stuff you eat, like from eggs or shellfish or liver, for example, that cholesterol you eat, it doesn't turn into these particles very efficiently at all, so much so that you probably shouldn't worry about it. Does that mean that you could eat eggs or should eat eggs? Yeah, probably. However, saturated fat does create more of these LDL particles. And so while some of the advice was very, very misguided in the 70s and the 80s and the 90s, some of it was accurate, and specifically saturated fat. And so when you think about reducing these particles, the biggest movers will be reducing the amount of saturated fat in your diet, losing weight if you're carrying extra weight, boosting up your fiber through high fiber foods or through a fiber supplement, through diet, lifestyle, exercise, and potentially through statins. So what would we like our ideal LDL levels to be? People argue about this, people have different reference ranges, but under 90 is a generally agreed upon number for ApoB particles. And someone like Dr. Peter Attia would recommend even under 50 or under 40. That kind of level is probably not possible with diet and lifestyle. You probably need to think about a statin. I have no idea whether you should take a statin or not. People tend to respond pretty well if you look at the swaths of data that's out there. I don't take them. I have a whole bunch of life ahead of me. I'm open to taking them sometime in the future. But right now, looking at my blood panels, I don't see any reason why I would take them. But I think it would be, you'd be foolish not to at least consider it if you have problematic LDL particle numbers. Statins are really well tolerated. Some people do get muscle cramps that make it a non-starter. And a very small percentage of people will get blood glucose dysregulation. But you probably want to try the lifestyle things as well. And you might try both in conjunction. The important thing to remember is just because you fix your cholesterol in the short term doesn't mean you can unwind years or decades of problems as quickly. Meaning if you were to change your diet and your lifestyle or go on a statin, within a week, your panels will improve. But remember, atherosclerosis is a very slow-moving disease. And that plaque that you have in your artery walls, that's very often years or decades old. The reason I mention that is because we'll come back to this, should I just eat a bunch of red meat and forget it? If you were to look at the epidemiological studies and the data that we do have, I think the answer is no. However, some of these influencers and some of these nutritional experts who are leaning heavily into foods that do bump up your cholesterol and even these bad driver LDL cholesterols, their assumption is that because their metabolic health is good, because their weight and their body composition is good, their theory is that they can handle it. And this is to be determined. I think it's a very interesting experiment. I think it's a very risky experiment. It's not something I would do or recommend, but I do understand what they're up to. But these are really, really high risk scenarios. And if you were to play it safe and if you were to optimize for longevity, I don't think you'd make the choice to run around with really, really high levels of LDL particles. I hope this video has been helpful for you. I apologize for the silly toys and the analogies, but hopefully it's cleared some things up for you. I'll put a link down below to a PDF that summarizes what we talked about. I'll also put a link to Dr. Peter Attia's book. It's excellent. I encourage you to check it out. I teach science-based yoga. You can hit subscribe down below. I release a video every week. You can find my teaching calendar at yogabody.com. If you have a story about ApoB, about manipulating your cholesterol levels, about eating all meat diet and what it's done to your blood panels, I'd love to hear from you down in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.